Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to share files using iCloud from your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now often you want to share a file or group of files with another person. You may be tempted to send that file in an email or a message, but not everybody is thrilled about getting a large attachment. Sometimes you're not in a convenient place to download that attachment and you'd rather download it when you're ready. Sharing a file using a cloud service is a much better idea. You could just send a link and then the person who receives either the email or message can download it when they want. Plus, you can actually really share a file this way. Instead of passing something back and forth, you could access the same file. So one person can make changes and the other person would instantly see them. The file is truly a shared file between people, but they could also make their own copy of the file, or you can make a copy of the file and share that copy. You can also share an entire folder full of files using iCloud Drive. So let's say, for instance, you want to share a document, like this Pages document here. So the first thing is to make sure that you're using iCloud Drive. Now, if you're using iCloud Drive for all your files, like I am, then this is no problem. All your files are ready for sharing. If not, you can make a copy of it and put it in iCloud Drive or just move it to iCloud Drive for sharing. Now, you can start sharing many different ways. For instance, you could select the file and go to File and then Share and then Share File. You could also select the file and then click the Actions button here, or you can Control click, right click on the mouse, two finger click on the trackpad and select Share and then Share File. These will all take you to the same place, a dialog that looks like this. And you could see here how to share it. Now, this isn't really how to share the file. This is how to notify the person that the file is being shared. So you can send them an email, send them something by message, or you can just copy the link and send it any way that you want. You could also AirDrop if they're nearby. This will just send the link, not the file itself. Now here you can specify the Apple ID of whoever you want to share it with. But if they don't have an Apple ID, you can put their email address there and that's where the notification will go. Then they could deal with it on their end as to how they receive the file. You can select only people you invite to get it. And this is typical if you want to share with one other person, you're going to want to specify their email address and they're the only ones that get it. But you could also do anyone with a link, meaning you can make this public. So lots of people can actually access this. All they need is a link. They don't need any special privileges. Then you could also set permission. They can make changes to the document or view only. So if you just want to give somebody a file, but you don't want them making changes to the file on your drive, then say view only. And that way they can view it, they can download a copy, but they can't make changes to your copy of it. So decide which of those options that you want. So for instance, if you want to just give somebody a file, let's say view only and only people that we invite. And then you type the Apple ID or the name of the person if they're in your contacts and you can select the method. So for instance, we'll just copy a link here and we'll hit share. Now I'm going to open up a new private window just so we could simulate what somebody else sees when they look at the link. I'll paste this link in here. So here's what they would see then when they open the URL in Safari. You get a little preview of the document, the name of the document, and you can open it in Pages. Now if you choose to open it in Pages, you can save your own copy of it, but you can't change the original. And if they're not on a Mac, they could still open it using the web app version of Pages, so they can still access the document. So for instance, here I am in the web app version of Pages here. So you see now I can open it in the actual Pages app since I am on a Mac. And you can see this is set to view only, so I can't actually edit it. But I can click here and download my own copy of it. But let's say I share an image. What happens then? I'm going to select this image here, share a file. I'll just use copy link here, but I will send it to that same person, set it to view only again, and share. Now when I go to this URL, I'll get this screen here. So here it's showing the name of the image, and I can add it to my iCloud Drive right here. So let me do that. And now you can see it takes me into the iCloud Drive app on the web, but I can see the same thing if I look on my Mac in my iCloud Drive folder. The image is now there. So I have my own copy of it. Also right here from the web, I could use this button right here to actually download that file locally. Now if you want to change how a file is shared, you could select it and go through those steps again, except this time you'll see Manage Shared File instead of Share File. So when I select that, it will show me here that I'm the owner and I have options here. It'll show me anybody that I've shared it with, and I've got options here as well. I can change the access to it, I could copy the link again. I could stop sharing or add more people to share it with. So let's stop this one from sharing and let's share another document instead. Let's share this one. But this time I'm going to set it to anyone with the link, view only. So this is still semi-secure because the link is really obscure. It's not going to be something it could just be easily guessed or is found somewhere when you search online. So for quickly sharing a document that doesn't need that much security to somebody else, you can do this temporarily until they get the file. And this way they don't have to mess with their Apple ID or even worrying if they have an Apple ID or iCloud account. So now when I paste this link in here in a private window, I will see this right here. And you can see here in addition to add to my iCloud Drive, since I am on a Mac with iCloud Drive, I can also just click download a copy. And then it will download directly to my downloads folder. That's probably your simplest option. And take a look at this URL here. You can see it's pretty much the equivalent of an ID and password because it's so long. You have to know all of this information in order to access this file. So it's pretty easy to share it with somebody. As soon as they send you an email back or a message saying, hey, thanks, I got it, then you can go back to the file here, go to manage shared file, and then stop sharing that file. And then you're done. Somebody else has gotten your file, but without having to create a large attachment or try to communicate back and forth about how to best share the file. Now the next level is to share a folder. So, for instance, I can take this folder here called Example Files. I can use the same methods to access sharing for it, but this time it says Share Folder, and now I can use one of these methods here and share the entire folder. And so let's set this up for only people I invite, enter the Apple ID for that person, and let's set this one to view only. So I'll share this. Let's paste that in here to a private window. And you can see here I could add it to my iCloud Drive. So once I do that, now if I look in my iCloud Drive folders, I've got all of those files available to me. You can see here at the top level of iCloud Drive, Example Files shared by MACMOST Demo is right there. And I can see this in the Finder as well. Now on the web here, I can select any file I want and download it. But of course, looking in iCloud Drive, the files are just there. I can't edit them, but I can make copies of them and view them. And the best thing about a shared folder is that I could add files to this and those new files will show up. So for instance, let's take this Alice document here. I'm going to copy it and I'm going to go in here and paste it in. And you can see it's now in there. Then here when I refresh this page, that new file is there. It's shared with that person. So if there's a person you need to share files with on a regular basis, you can just create a shared folder for that person and put that in iCloud Drive, and then any files you want to share with them, just add to that folder. So here's what it looks like on the other end. Somebody has just shared a folder with me and they decided to send me a notification by text message. So you can see I got this text message. Go in here and it says open my shared folder, and I can click it. And then it will ask me if I want to open this, and I'll say yes. And then you can see it's going to open a new Finder window right away here with the test folder. So this is the folder that was shared with three documents in there. If I look in iCloud Drive, I could see test right there. Now I can open up a file here, but this is set to view only. So you can see here it says view only. But I can always duplicate it, or I'm going to hold the Option key down here and save as. I can also drag and drop and we'll make a copy of that file. So this is read-only sharing here. I can view and I could copy a version of it, but I can't change the version that the owner of the file has. And then if you choose different options, like for instance, you choose can make changes, then that person can also put files in there and you can see them. So it could be the shared folder between the two of you. An easy way to transfer things. You could just send them a message saying, hey, that new file you wanted, it's now in our shared folder. And then they would be able to get it. And then they could put a file for you in there as well. And you could share this folder with a whole bunch of people, say classmates that you're working on a project with or team members at work, and you could all put shared files in there. If they don't have an Apple ID or they're not even on a Mac, they could still get access to them and still use the web interface to upload files to it. Remember, Apple IDs and iCloud Drive accounts are free. You don't need to have a Mac to sign up for one. You could just create your own account and use it for sharing. And also keep in mind that other cloud services like Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive, and Google Drive all work the same way. So you can create shared folders and shared files in those and use those to share with others as well. And there's no reason not to use multiple ones. So for instance, if you have a team that's already using Dropbox for something, continue to use Dropbox. And if you want to create something and you decide you want to use iCloud Drive for that, you can use iCloud Drive for that. You don't have to choose one and only use that cloud solution. You can use whichever one fits the situation best. So if you have to share large files with people, use a cloud service like iCloud Drive to share those files instead of having them as attachments in email or sending them some other way. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.